Hello.
Ian.
Yeah.
I can hear the fan in the background.
There's not a fan going. Give me a second.
Is it Valheim? might just be Valheim.
I don't really know. Sorry.
If it's just Valheim, it's not your fault. I can hear your game.
Give a second. Is that better?
Yeah. I can still hear it slightly, but you can hear a reverberation of my voice. It's not as bad as it was. Kyle's not getting on you.
Not at all tonight?
No, he's in Vegas.
Oh, so this is just gonna be us.
I don't know if Nate's gonna get on. He said something to the fact that his parents have crappy Wi-Fi and he wasn't sure if he'd be able to get on. Nate might get on Ian, but it kind of just depends on his internet, I guess.
Are you by chance near bed? Noah.
Can you still hear me?
Yeah, I can now. free tin on me.
most of us won't break a world record, but feel great after breaking a sweat. Most of us are dreamers.
In today's video, I'm going to show you how you can tame and breed wolves. As you can see, we've got a couple of cubs here. They're the cutest little things in the game. This was a super exciting progression in the game for me, and I can't wait to show you guys how this is done. So the first thing that you'll need to do is find yourself a mountain biome. And really, the only way to do this is explore your map. All of the map generations in Valheim are random, so you just have to look around until you find one. It is characterized by, well, mountains and snow and fir trees, as you see here. Now, don't go into this biome, because if you do, a couple of things can happen. Well, one thing definitely will happen, actually, and that is you'll start to freeze. So if you walk in too far, there we go, I'm freezing now, just to show you guys. So if in that case, you have to get out of there, but you will start taking damage instantly. The other thing is, obviously, this is where the wolves live, right? That's why we have to find the mountain biome in the first place. And if you go too close to a mountain biome, like even here, I'm a little bit too close, because wolves, if they spawn nearby, they will come and tear you to shreds, quite literally. Okay, so you got yourself a mountain biome. Well, this is my, here's one I did earlier moment, and this is what you need to build next to set yourself up. So what's going to happen is you're going to get a wolf to chase you. You're going to get into here. When you get in here, you're able to jump up onto this thing right here and into safety, because the wolf will not be able to jump up, and then you can trap the wolf in. So as you can see, all I've got are these little stake walls here all the way around, apart from here, so that I can build this so we can jump up. What I've got here is one of these tall walls, and I've double built it. So a wall there and a wall there, and that should be thick enough so that when the wall is it. Sorry, wolf, I should say, is in here and he's angry. He'll attack the fences and stuff, but with the stake walls, you'll be fine. And with that there, you should be good too. You want to have the crafting area here, the workbench here, because what you can do is repair the walls as he starts to attack them. But also, you're going to need to build a wall in there, and I'll show you guys that in just a second. The other thing, make sure you've got some raw meat nearby. You're going to be using this in order to tame the wolf. Again, I'll show you that, but just make sure you have it there. So you want an area set up like this. Around the back, I've just made like this so I can jump up and get to this. Because the wolf, as you may see later, I don't know how this one's going to go, but sometimes they won't come straight into here. They'll start running around the back and stuff like that and attacking things. So this ensures that the wolf can't come up here and get us, because they're pretty, like, they'll attack you and they'll do a lot of damage. The other thing you might want is one of these, a little waiting room nearby. Now, this is sort of optional in a way, but essentially you will need something like this, because wolves, you need to be sort of close to them for them to start being tamed and eating the meat that you leave for them. So I've just made a little thing like this. Again, I had to jump up, so I'm safe in here. I've got my little door here that I can come into like this, and I can keep an eye on the pen and just sit down like this. Now, you could make something that's nearby that doesn't have a visual, but later on in the video, you're going to see why a visual might be preferable. And, you know, you can get creative and make this however you want, but an area like this is definitely a good idea. So in a second, we're going to venture off into the mountain biome and get a wolf to chase us back down into here. And I'm going to talk about that in a second. But first, we do need to discuss how we're going to survive the cold. And as you saw before, you will freeze if you don't take this into consideration. So you got a couple of options. First of all, you could build campfires, right? So if I build a campfire up here like this, I can stand near this. Now, you'll still get cold, but you won't get the freezing debuff. You see, there we go, you feel cold, but you won't freeze. So that is an option. However, it's a little bit tedious having to place several of these, because as you're running off, you have to keep placing more of them as you go through in order to stay warm. Oh my god, okay, right, I was not expecting that wolf to come get me. If you see a wolf like that, particularly when, like I am there, you're not ready for it, just run and get out of there. But yeah, so this is essentially what we're going to do, right, is try and get the wolf trapped like this. So when you're up here like this, you're going to get the stake wall in your hand like this, and you're going to have it ready to place. When he comes in there, you're going to place it. So I've accidentally sort of skipped ahead a bit of the tutorial here. We'll leave him in there for now, because it's sort of handy that he's there, I suppose. Hopefully he's not going to, like, destroy too much of these walls and things. We'll just try and sort of get those. But you might have noticed, as I was running away from the wolf, I actually started to freeze. That is another problem with these campfires, is that when you're running away from the wolf, you can't do it slowly or, like, necessarily very accurately. You just need to hightail it out of there. And so, you know, you might start getting the freezing debuff then. Another issue with the campfires is that as it snows, they will actually go out. In the same way that when it rains, they'll go out. When it snows, they will go out too. So in my opinion, a much better bet is to use the frost resistance mead. The only issue with this is the recipe, as we're about to see. It does require you to go to the swamp. So let's have a quick look at that and then discuss that a bit further. So the benefit of the campfires is the ease of use, because all you need is wood and stones, of course, to get them burning up. And those are all obviously very early game things. In order to get the mead, what you'll need is a cauldron. And the mead recipe for frost resistance here, you'll need honey, thistles, blood bags, and great ore fires. Now, you should know how to get just about all of that stuff at this stage of the game, but the blood bags you might not be familiar with. You get those from leeches, which you find in swamps. They're one of the drops when you kill leeches. So it does require going to swamp, killing them, that sort of thing. It will also require you to have a fermenter. So you make up the mead, Then you get that mead and you put it into the fermenter. Now, when you do this, it will take a couple of in-game days to ferment up, and it will give you a batch of 6 of these potions right here. Now, each of these lasts for 10 minutes, so every time you take one, or make a batch, I should say, you get 6, right? So you've got an hour, which is plenty for getting your wolf. The good thing about them is once you've taken them, you can run through the forest, the mountain biome, without any issues at all. So depending on what stage of the game you're at, I do highly recommend the frost resistance mead, but the campfire's there as a backup if you're trying to do this very early game. Okay, so we're actually going to kill this wolf here that we trapped, because we didn't really mean to trap him. And I want to show you guys properly how to do this from start to finish, right? So there he goes, he dies. And the drops you'll get from them will be like wolf pelt. And you can see that you get wolf trophies as well. And you can use this for all kinds of cool stuff, like making up the wolf fur cape and that sort of thing. But anyway, let's go ahead and get rid of this and let's repair our fences that he's just been attacking, right? Make sure that we're all good here. There we go. So when the next one comes in, there's no weak spots that he could attack. Okay, so in terms of getting the wolf stuck in here, obviously you've seen the preparation in terms of like building this up, having the raw meat, having your little waiting room, which looks like a little bird butcher's hut, doesn't it? but there's a few more things to talk about. So stamina is going to be really useful in this, and so I recommend you eat food that'll give you a lot of stamina. Some reasonably early to mid-game options in terms of that are the Queen's Jam, the carrot soup, and also the cooked meat is not too bad either. So that's going to give you a lot of stamina, which is important because you're going to be doing a lot of running. Now, at this point, what I'd say is have your shield equipped, but just put it on your back using R so you can get it back out for easy access. And at that point, what you want to do is go ahead and drink your frost resistance mead. And as you see there in the top right of my screen, you get the whole 10 minutes there in order to get this sort of used, you know, while you find the wolf. Now, what I recommend as well is you'll notice on my minimap here, what I've done is made a little bit of an icon here where we're heading for, right, where this base area is. Now, the reason for that is when we're in here, we don't know how far in we're going to have to go before the wolf spawns, right? So we're just going to run in, and when we see a wolf, what we're going to do is hightail it back to that area. And you're going to see this on cam in a second. Trees in the way here. But yeah, so in terms of like that, we don't know how far we're going to go, which is why, A, you want to have lots of this frost-resistant meat on you in case you need more than the 10 minutes. And also to have that little icon or map to aim for. Once you've been running around this biome a little bit, it could be, you know, you might get disoriented. And the last thing you want is to be able to not find your little area that you've made for the wolves. Now, in terms of finding the wolves, you want to try and see them from a distance. I recommend that you don't sprint or jump through this biome unless you have to. I want you to save all of your stamina in case you know, this chase goes on for quite a long time. So I'm going to go ahead and have a little snoop around until I find a wolf, and then we'll see what we're going to do at that point. Okay, guys, down there is a wolf. Now, what we're going to do is get close enough that he can see us. Another thing you could do is shoot an arrow at it. So I know where I got ahead because I've got my sort of portal thing there, like, lined up. And okay, so as soon as he starts chasing, you want to hightail it. Now, when I said shoot an arrow at it, I didn't mean you need to hit it with an arrow. If you shoot an arrow near its feet, it should come for you. Now, you can see here why I wanted to make sure I knew exactly where I was going, because it's quite a long chase, and this is also why I wanted to make sure I had plenty of stamina. So there we go. Now he's in the area. Okay, good. So now we just need to get him into this little bit. We don't want him attacking our stuff, so what we're going to do is come down here, let him see us, come and chase us. So he loses interest in the portal. I made a portal nearby just so I could portal to him from this area. Not a terrible idea. Is he going to come in? So this is the bit that can be a bit finicky. If we stand here, there we go, he's trying to get us. So now at this point, we can go ahead and get ready to build this. So do make sure you have at least 4 wood on you to build this stake wall. Okay, at this point, what you want to do is get your food out and go ahead and chuck it in on the floor there so he can get to that. You can now get your hammer out and just repair some of these walls if you want, just to make sure he's not going to break anything. And at this point, we're going to get away from here and we're going to go, let's call it the Bird Watcher's Hut. We're going to go up to the Bird Watcher's Hut, the waiting room, whatever you guys want to call it, right? And as I say, this is pretty makeshift because I'm only using it for this. You can make it nicer than this. You can make it not as nice as this. But from here, we can go ahead, press X, and just kind of sit down and watch what happens. Okay, so I don't know if you guys are seeing this, but one of the good things about sitting here watching like this is you can actually see the love hearts, right? So those are the sort of like the tame hearts, and you can just keep an eye on the fact that he is being tamed and this process is working. Now, as I said, you will just need to sit here for a while in order for him to become tame. And if you go too far away from the air, then it won't work. But while you're sat here like this and he's being tamed, he's not attacking the fences or anything. So you can actually just sit here the whole time until he's tame. You know, go off, put the kettle on, have a lovely cup of tea, something like that. And when you come back, he'll be tamed. So I'm going to test how long this takes and how much food this takes for him to be fully tamed. And I'll let you guys know once that's done. So just add a bit of a thought. When you sleep and you have stuff smelting, that smelting happens a lot faster overnight. And I just wondered whether this might be the same if we can sleep over here. So I made this very makeshift little bed here with a fireplace and that, so we can test this tonight. So what I want to do is just jump up here real quick, if I can do that. Hello, Mr. Wolf. How tame are you? Tell me. All right. Tamed is 30% and he's hungry. There is food in the pen, so he can eat the food. So now what I'm going to do is have a little sleep and see if this changes overnight or not. So let's have a little sleep here. And, you know, if it goes up to like 50% or something, then I guess we know that it works. And if it's on like 31 or 2 or something like that, then could have just been that he's eaten a little bit of meat in, you know, the seconds here that are passing. So just thought I'd test this on cam. We'll find out together, guys, whether or not this works. Fingers crossed, because it would be pretty cool if it did. And let's go back to the wolf and see whether or not you work. So I just need to look at you again. Tameness, 31%. I would say then it doesn't like do anything, so that's fine. At least we found out together. Alrighty, guys, so right now we have a wolf, and as you can see there, he is tame, he is happy. There's 15 raw meat left, so it only actually took me 5 raw meat in order to tame him. Now I don't know if this can vary or, you know, might depend on different things, but that's just my experience so far. So we press E to pet him now. There we go, wolf follows you, it says, and we pet him again, wolf stays. So let's go ahead and have a little look at this. Let's get rid of this and let's hit wolf follows you. So come on in, wolf. Let's go off and see what's happening, shall we? If I run away, you coming? I mean, maybe he's trying to follow me and he's kind of stuck. There he goes. Difficult that's going to be. So what I'm going to do at this point is get the stakes. So he's howling. He's just so happy. He just loves me. That's what that is. So there's a couple of things you could do here. Like, you could make a little side pen around here, for example, right? And then try and push him in, get him to follow you in, throw some meat in to get him in, whatever, you know, keep him separate. What I'm going to do, just as like a little test for us to see if this is going to work or not, is just try and run in with a new wolf. So let's see how that goes. I'm going to repeat the process you guys saw before. We're going to eat all of our stuff here. We're going to go ahead, we'll step in and take... He went and said, loves me. I mean... Done it again. What? This is the stupidest wolf. Hey! Right, okay. Yeah, no, he's coming. Okay. He had to go. Oh, no, now that I'm not going my way. Oh my god. I've never seen this before ever. Like, my dead body's here now. I'm carrying too much? I think he killed my wolf. Oh, wait. Are you the. Oh, you're the tame one. Protect yourself. So I actually missed this on the first wolf, but it does come up in yellow on your screen saying wolf has been tamed. Funnily enough, when the wolf has been tamed. So I'm sure now this one is also tamed, right? So hey buddy, we've got 2 happy wolves right here. Now we have 11 meat left. So this one actually only took 4, I believe. Oh, that means I'm carrying 2. You know what? Actually, we want to leave the meat here anyway, because we want these guys to breed. So next thing is to let this dude back in, right? So where's my get my hammer out. Break this right here. So there you go. Yep, you're back in. And let's actually just like close that off. And yeah, we'll go ahead and get rid of this. So we get rid of this right here. You can at this point as well just do a final repair if you want, because now this stuff isn't going to get destroyed, at least by these wolves. But if you're in the area, obviously things like gradings that might come and try to destroy it. So we should have a little look around here now, see what happens in the breeding process, and I'll keep you guys posted as we go. Okay, guys, I was just playing around with them there. I don't know if you saw that, but you had the pink hearts that came out of the wolves. So the pink hearts means they have successfully mated. So they're interacting, and you'll see these pink little hearts.
Yes. I'm so happy about that.